Okay, so hopefully before you watch this video, make sure you've watched the reading of the book Tuesday by David Wiesner, who is a very well-known illustrator. It's a Caldecott winner, and Caldecott, kind of like, hopefully you know what the Newbery Medal is. The Caldecott winners are those that are known for their illustrations. So it's a Caldecott winner. He did a lot of others too. You might look him up. There's a lot of really cool books that he's done that are really neat. And so after reading that, I want you to think about what might happen the next Tuesday. So this week, all of the frogs were flying. What might happen the next Tuesday? Okay. And then, so the first thing I want you to do is just brainstorm a little bit. So I want you to spend 3 to 5 minutes, get a piece of scratch paper and get a pen, because it's not about erasing your ideas. It's just dumping out as many ideas as you can. So hopefully you can get at least 10, dump out at least 10 different ideas about what could happen the next Tuesday. And you're not drawing them, you're just writing something down, things that will spark your imagination. Okay, go. Okay, hopefully you spent 3 to 5 minutes and you have 10 ideas written down. And I'm going to share mine with you and kind of my process, how I came up with them. And I really don't want you to steal mine unless you had it already, but I do want you to think about the process, and maybe my ideas will spark some ideas of your own as well. So I just started off with things being able to fly. So I thought about fruit flying, because I thought fruit flies, ha ha ha, that's funny. Horses would be flying the next time. And then I thought, what if it's the opposite? Instead of something flying, something that did fly then goes underground. So then I went, birds would burrow. And then I was thinking about things that were underground. I'm like, well, what could I do with worms instead of them just flying? Well, what if worms are small? So what if I did the opposite? What if they became giant? What if the worms become giants overnight and they walk through town? And then I thought about, well, what's something else that's giant that could become small? So I turn it around that way, and I thought, well, how about the moon? What if the moon becomes small and like grows arms and legs and walks around during the nighttime? And so then I was thinking about things having arms and legs, and I thought about, well, what about if the corn stalks on the farm, because they already kind of look, they have ears, you know, but you could make the stalks look like kind of like people, and they could walk through and come alive during the night. And then I thought, well, what other things could come alive that aren't alive? And I thought about, what about all the farm vehicles? What if all the things on the farm or the vehicles in town, what if they came alive and were human? And then I thought, well, what are other things that could become human-like and like talk to each other and do human type things, even though they're not human overnight? And so I thought, well, what if all the barn animals all of a sudden could talk? And I know that's been done other places before, so I probably wouldn't do that one. So then I thought, well, what if the mice become human and like they have their own little society and all this stuff going on that they pull out at nighttime on Tuesday? Or, and then the last thing I thought, what if everything inside the refrigerator comes alive on the next Tuesday? So there were my 10 different ideas. So I want you to take 10 of of those ideas. I want you to take four different ones, and I want you to sketch them out. And so take your paper and your scratch paper. I'm doing one here. Oops, I already got stuff on that. I got stuff everywhere, wouldn't you know? On the back of this, but so you'll take this, you fold it in half this way, fold it in half again. Okay. All right, sorry if I'm drawing. I've got four squares. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, in each square, I want you to take a little time. Don't put in a ton of details. It's just enough to get an idea. You call this a quick sketch. So it really should not take more than 3 to 5 minutes per sketch. It doesn't have to be beautiful. It just has to get the idea across. So do a quick sketch of your four different ideas. So let's say your idea is the animals and the barn talk at night. You do that on one. Then the next one has to be the moon comes down and walks around on the earth. And then the next one is a corn stalks walking. And the next one is a fruit flying. You can't do the same idea four different times. It's four different ideas drawn out. And then what I want you to do is show those ideas to another classmate and neighbor. I don't want you to go running all around the room, just somebody sitting next to you, and see what, if you don't say a thing, You don't tell them anything. You shouldn't have anything labeled on your drawing. Just show it to them and see if they can figure out what happened on the next Tuesday. Because if they can, then you have a good illustration, because illustrations tell stories, okay, without words, without telling people what's going on. So, if they can do it, then you have a good illustration. If they can't, then that's probably not a good one. So pick the one then that you think is best, and then you're going to start drawing it large. Okay, and this will probably take you one whole class period to get this far. So get that done, and then we'll do another video on starting your drawing.